It's getting late. Time to go. That beautiful memory is so distant that it has become distorted. Bring along the investigation records. They may come in handy. Nice to meet you. Investigating the mining disaster in Golden Cave. My plan was to interview the survivors. But before I left, I received a message from a colleague who'd been out of reach for days. She'd finally obtained an invitation to Aletus Manor with the help of an ingenious disguise. I decided to assume her identity and return to my paradise from long ago. The now infamous manor. My gut told me it might be my only chance to unravel its secrets with my own hands. Hi. I received an invitation.
Please come with me. My apologies, but we weren't expecting you today. The Lord of the Manor isn't here, but another guest has arrived.
Crafted gloves, worn out of habit, but there are signs of wear between the thumb and index fingers. Has a relaxed demeanor, fits in very well here, and doesn't look like a newcomer. Well dressed in properly maintained clothes, but they were in vogue 3 years ago.
Mr. Creeperk, this is, the reporter? I see. It's a pleasure to meet you.
The pleasure's all mine. You can call me...
Hello. I'm Frederick Creeperk.
Mr. Creeperk, your performance was truly moving. Is it your own creation?
It was composed by a friend of my father's.
Your father was a composer?
Indeed. Many in my family, me included, received the call of Euterpe.
Mr. Creeperk, may I ask why you came to this manor?
Forgive me. I'm afraid we are not close enough for me to share this secret with you. I'm a little tired. So I plan to return to my room. Farewell.
A familiar, yet unfamiliar place. A little old, simply maintained, but cleaned well. painting from my childhood. Perhaps they are one and the same? This was my father's favorite piano. I clearly remember it being destroyed in that accident, but someone has restored it. This place is exactly like the manor I remember. If my memory isn't deceiving me, of course.
Your room is ready. Please come with me. This is your room. I'll excuse myself if there's nothing else you need.
Can I have a moment of your time to ask you a few questions?
Of course.
Mr. Butler, when did Mr. Kreberg arrive here?
Mr. Kreberg arrived the day before yesterday.
He introduced himself as a composer?
Not entirely. Mr. Kreberg is very popular in high society. He's a well-known new classical talent around here. But when it comes to composing, he doesn't seem to have inherited his father's gift.
Where is he staying now?
Mr. Kreberg suffers from mild psychasthenia and does not like being disturbed, so we placed him in the guest room at the end of the second floor.
To my knowledge, there should be more guests. Have they arrived yet?
Besides Mr. Kreberg and you, there are Mrs. Plinius and Mr. Orpheus. They will arrive as planned tomorrow.
Orpheus? The popular novelist?
Indeed. The writer of suspense novels who has made quite a reputation for himself lately. I'm sure you've read his work.
Where will he stay?
Mr. Orpheus is in the guest room on the east side. He seems interested by the Lord's collection in the corridor.
Mrs. Plinius? The widow of...
Indeed. She's a very famous entomologist herself, and she has quite an insight into the study of plants and animals.
Where will she stay?
Mrs. Plinius is in the guest room on the western side of the main building's ground floor. It gives her convenient access to the greenhouse.
Has the Lord made any other plans?
Once all the guests have arrived, the Lord will tell you what to do next. Please wait patiently until then. You must be exhausted from the journey here, so please get some rest. I won't take up any more of your time. Dinner is served at 6. The servants return to their quarters at 11, and they prepare breakfast at 6 in the morning. Feel free to ask if you need anything else.
Thracian girl carrying the head of Orpheus on his lyre. It's a part of my father's collection. According to my previous investigations, it should have been sold off by our greedy relatives, just like the painting in the living room. But someone has brought it back here again. This used to be my bedroom, but it has been modified into a guest room now. Not a single trace of my past life can be seen here. Thank you. I'll have the chance to discuss this book with Mr. Orpheus. I need to learn more about the environment here before I can proceed. I paid special attention to the surroundings on the way here. I didn't expect to return here like this. Even though the interior of the second floor has changed, the entire building seems to be an intentional restoration of the main building from back then. So this floor plan Father drew himself should be of use. Maybe I should investigate the first floor today. It will all become harder to control once the other two guests arrive tomorrow. But I must wait until the servants go to sleep. So where should I start?